Hey guys, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Catherine, and today I'm showing you what's on my iPhone. So I recently got the iPhone 11 Pro Max, and I love it so much. I 10 out of 10 recommend this phone, so if you're thinking about getting one of these, I think you should for sure. And I got this as a birthday slash graduation gift, and it's my favorite phone that I've had yet. And I'm just gonna jump right into what I'm showing you. And my favorite feature about this phone is probably the camera. So if you're wondering if the camera is actually that good, it is. And the 11 Pro Max has the three cameras, and it's like really cool. I can show you. I want to start off by showing you my case. I got this case from casely.com, like my favorite case ever. It's one of their bold cases, so it's like supposed to be extra protective. It looks like it has stickers all over the back, but they're like made onto the phone case. I just thought this was super cute. So to start off, this is my lock screen. I just thought this wallpaper was like the cutest. My sister sent it to me, and I also set it as my home screen background. And I just love having Face ID because I upgraded from the iPhone 7 Plus to the 11 Pro Max, and it's like a big step, but I just love it. And I literally use my phone for everything now because it's that great. And at the bottom of my home screen, I have my phone and my messages app because those are like the main two apps that I use for communication, and they're just right there all the time, so I can just click them if I need them right away. And on this page, on my home screen, I have Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, all of my social medias, as you can see. I also have other messenger apps, and I mainly use GroupMe for like work and when I was on Color Guard. And I have Safari, YouTube Studio, all my music apps. So this page is basically just like entertainment. And I have that Disney World app because me and my best friend are going there for our senior trip, and that just has like a map and like all of our dinners and stuff that we're going to, and it's really cool. Netflix is what I use to watch all my favorite shows and movies. I also have FaceTime. Usually when I call people on FaceTime, I just use the phone button anyways. This is just social media, entertainment. I've got my app store because that's where I buy my apps. And my next page is basically all things related to camera and photos and editing. This is the camera. It's like really good, and if I wanted to take a picture of my lamp, this is what it looks like. You can click the 0.5 button and it'll like zoom all the way out, and you can get everything like around it. And if you hit the 2, it like zooms all the way in, and 1 is just regular. Portrait mode, you can do it on the back camera, or you can also do it on this side of the camera, which I think is really cool because my old phone didn't have that feature where you can switch it around. The camera's just really good on here. I have my photos and camera connect. That's what I connect my camera with, so I can get any pictures or videos off of there and move them to my phone. It works via Wi-Fi. Google Photos, if anyone wants to share like a photo album with me, that's what I use to see them. And then all the apps below that is everything that I use to edit my pictures and or videos. And these are my favorite apps. I recommend Tezza. You have to pay like $2.99 a month if you want to unlock like all the filters, and I do that, but it's worth it. Like, their filters are really good, and everything that you get with that is great. And you can also edit videos if you pay that. And then iMovie, CuteCut Pro, and Thumbnail Maker I use for YouTube. Also the other apps above that, because sometimes I throw in some filters and words and stuff. My next page is apps that I need, like fitness related, if it's like restaurant shopping, and just other like necessities that I use. I talked about MyFitnessPal in one of my other videos. I just track like what I eat every day on there, and Planet Fitness is right next to it. And then the activity app, which is on my Apple Watch, you can view your activity rings, and it tells you how like active you're being, how many calories you burn, how many minutes of activity you've had, and hours standing. So that little group right there is just like fitness related. I have to use the Planet Fitness app anytime I go into the gym. Fruitables and Chipotle, those are like my rewards apps. So anytime I go and I like scan the apps, I get points, and I like add up to get like a free meal or something. And Shein, or Shein, however you say it, I say Shein. That's what I shop off of. They have really cute swimsuits and clothes, and it's all really cheap. They have cute shoes too. And I have my Bible app next to that. I usually read like my actual Bible, but I just have this on here in case I'm ever anywhere. Like when I was in high school and we had Christian fellowship or youth group and I didn't have my Bible on me, I had it on my phone. Those apps are free. I recommend getting one of those if you don't have a personal Bible. Wendy is a babysitting app. It's just where like anybody in the community, if they need a babysitter, they'll post a job, and anyone that is like a Wendy can accept the job and take it. Then I have like all my banking apps, and then weather, and then my GPS apps and Life360. I just use the regular weather app if I need to know like temperature or the radar. And then I usually use Waze as my GPS because it takes you like the fastest route. It also tells you like if there's a police ahead, a car stopped on the shoulder ahead, and it just like has like every little thing in it, and I just love that. And then Life360 is, you know, tracking. I'm sure you know what Life360 is. My next page is just like necessities on my phone. Some of them I don't even use. The settings app is right in the top left because everything that runs your phone is in your settings, whatever, you can regulate anything. And then I have my clock app next to my settings, and that's where I set all my alarms. As you can see, like I have alarms for like so many different times. So like if I'm getting up at like 6:15 in the morning, I'll set an alarm for that. And then I'll set 3 alarms after that just in case, because, you know, sometimes I don't want to get up. And then I have my calculator app because, you know, sometimes I gotta use a calculator because I don't feel like doing quick math in my head. And then I have notes and reminders. I actually use both of those a lot. And then calendar, I don't really use that app because I use my planner. I mean, sometimes I'll go in there real quick if I need to know what day a certain date is on. All the other necessities, I don't really use any of those in the middle. I use Files, Word, Drive, and Docs. Word is a great app. It's just like if you have Microsoft Word on your computer, you can use it on your phone on this app, and it's really great. If you don't have access to your computer in the moment, you can just use the app on your phone. And then this page on my home screen is everything that I need for college. I start in August, as you guys might already know if you saw my previous video. These are all the apps that they recommended us get for college. Duo has something to do with security. eAccounts is like payments and stuff. Passio Go is like where you can see all the bus routes on campus, like if I need to get on a bus to take me to a certain hall. Blackboard is where they post like assignments and stuff. TurboScan is where you can scan stuff in from your phone. You don't have to have like a printer or something, which I think is really cool. I didn't even know that existed until I did my online orientation. And then Zoom, I'm sure everybody is familiar with Zoom by now because of everything that has been going on. People are resorting to Zoom for everything, every kind of meeting, class, stuff like that. And then my last page on my phone is my games. I didn't have any games on my phone, but during quarantine, me and my sisters have just been playing around, and I downloaded all these games. These are like my favorite games. Games are just great to pass time, and especially during quarantine, if you are tired of watching like shows on Netflix or you don't have anything to do, I mean, I recommend you go outside or something, but sometimes you can't, and sometimes you just want to sit down and relax. I just love playing all these games. These are my favorites. And that's the last page on my home screen. I love this phone. It's literally my favorite phone I've had yet. So if you're thinking about getting this, like I said, I highly recommend it. And thank you guys so much for watching. I know this is just like a random video, but I heard that these are really popular. And if you're curious of what's on my iPhone, now you know. This is also kind of like a review too. And again, don't forget to follow my Christian TikTok account at @catlovesjesus. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel if you're interested in seeing more videos from me. I plan to post a video every Tuesday now. And I'm just so glad that you watched my video today, and I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys next time.